fans of Eurovision. I'm Tatiana Spiteri. This is Blogovision. Welcome to my channel. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe so that you stay in touch with everything going on in the world of Eurovision, where I go every year and participate as official press. Now, this time we are analyzing Loreen, or should it be pronounced in the Swedish way, Loreen, with the song Tattoo, which has all the chances and is now currently in Booker's first position to win Melodifestivalen and even somehow already in the odds to win the whole Eurovision 2023 in Liverpool. Like, the song hasn't even been confirmed or selected yet by Melodifestivalen in Sweden, but it's already predicted that A, Loreen's gonna win it, B, Loreen's gonna win the whole Eurovision and beat the other 36 countries. Now, let's take a look. Is it really that wow? Because I didn't watch the last hit of Melodifestivalen in Sweden. We all remember Loreen by Euphoria, forever till the end of time. It's everybody's favorite ever in Eurovision. Whoever I asked, press, fans, Eurovision, hardcore fans all say Loreen, Euphoria is their number one song. It has inspired so many people to start singing, to pursue it professionally, to become singers, and even to try themselves in national selections as well. So, can she beat her own success? It's always hard to go to Eurovision with already being a winner, and there's a question why as well. Is it not enough for you that you've already won it? But then again, they are, you know, musicians are creative creatures. They want to come back, they want to participate in national selections, they want to make a statement with their new song. Now, the new song is called Tattoo. What an unusual name for a song to win Eurovision, if it does. But let's see if it really has the winner vibes for both Melodifestivalen and Eurovision altogether. Let's go. Tattoo! Loreen! Yeah, so she's probably Loreen in Swedish pronunciation. Okay, what it looks like a tanning salon, you know, because she's lying so tightly in it. Well, what a pose as well, yeah, with the leg up. So subtle and so emotional. Whoa, look at those nails, girl. Look how little is happening, sort of, but how crowd is already going wild, no? Okay, I see that this, yeah, the platform is being lifted. Nice intro, nice pre-chorus. Ah, goosebumps from this voice, yeah? What a strong, incredibly strong voice. I see this Euphoria vibes, you see as well, like still this kind of a, you know, like sort of a everything in the fog or storm kind of surrounding, and she goes from lower to higher pitches to then kill it in the chorus. Has she even aged at all? She looks the same as she did so many years ago when she won with Euphoria. In the cookie. Angels crying. Stay there. Angels crying. That takes me back to people stop fighting. Angels are crying. The famous song by Morandi from Romania. People stop fighting. Angels are crying. Angels crying. We've heard it many times. Nothing new in terms of lyrics, but overall, awesome impression already. And like, I had to stop also because it's just so much to intake. You know, it's flying too fast. The song from this verses to pre-choruses to choruses. It's such a kind of kaleidoscope of everything. Yeah, it's both a visual treat. It's this Loreen herself with this postures and the nails and the attitude. But the voice is totally out of this world. I feel like we're listening to a studio version, not to the you know, not to the live first time kind of performance, because this is her first performance live, as far as I understand, the Melodifestivalen. And then when it comes to the final, damn, she'll kill it. Oh my God. Wow. Let's continue. I love this guy. Ha! What kind of like standing up and jumping back down? How is she keeping her voice that stable? Most of us, if we start jumping like that and moving around, will not keep it, you know? She's a great demonstration of, like, you don't have to be standing like a soldier. Yeah, you have to open your chest, you have to be stable to, you know, make it flawlessly. But it doesn't mean that you cannot move around the stage, that you cannot move your hands, you cannot, like, lift something up, you cannot go from sitting down to standing up. You are not a robot. Yeah, checkbox, not a robot. I kind of want more visually, though, from the staging, not from herself. She has done brilliantly. Culmination. Love it. Like, I'm the queen. I think everybody will be like, woo-hoo-hoo, in this Eurovision. It will be ringtone, woo-hoo-hoo, instead of, uh-oh, woo-hoo-hoo. Yeah, staging needs to be a bit elevated, and not elevated in terms of going up, it's already going up. It's elevating from beginning to end. Ah, she's just such a treat, both to ears and to eyes. Although, if you, you know, put everything away, a lot of this hair and makeup, it's not like Loreen is, I don't know, Miss Sweden 2023. But at the same time, like, to meet such a charismatic person, you know, it's like she's basically bringing the whole show down with this song already in Melodifestivalen. Now let's think about the fact that Bookies put her on the first position and say that Sweden might win this year's Eurovision. And again, we're heading to the north. So yeah, I mean, I don't see why not, you know, because A, people know Loreen, people love Loreen. Two, this is, well, to me, Euphoria is still a more memorable song, Euphoria, than woohoo. Yeah, but this has a lot of melody in it. This is singable as well. This is very modern. I feel like we are watching Grammy 2022 or 3. You know, I feel like this corresponds to what people are listening to in Europe, in the US, all over the world. Production is awesome. Staging needs to really be also reflecting that. For now, just the fact that there is a bit of a, you know, like smoke fog, and the platform is being lifted up as she starts standing up. On Loreen's part, though, everything is awesome. Flawless. Flawless victory.
Flawless victory.
Will it be her flawless victory in Eurovision 2023? If she does progress to that, well, first of all, I would totally choose this for Melodifestivalen as a winner. Now, it will be really tough, you know, this year, what have we got? So, I was thinking of it and I cannot even believe it. So, we've got Sweden, Loreen, probably. We've got Norway with the Vikings, Alessandra, and really powerful voice as well for such a young singer. And she's killing it as well. It's like even going to this whistling, you know, pitches, which will make the audience go nuts, you know, and vote for her. She, queen of the keys, broken a cage, threw the keys. She will be the warrior. Also, incredibly charismatic, wonderful effect. A bit banal, maybe typical for Eurovision, but it doesn't mean this cannot win. And it totally can be top 3, top 5, yeah? And then we've got Finland with Cha-Cha-Cha. Which is so crazy that even though the song is melodically quite a mess of all kinds of styles, you know, it still can win. Because people love fun, people love craziness, people love Finnish quirkiness, people like when they don't understand what's going on, but they surely cannot go to the kitchen or toilet, because this is not a break time. This is in your face, and this is memorable, and in the recap, Cha-Cha-Cha will kill it if they choose the right recap moment, and people will be nuts. Yeah, so we're looking at Sweden, Norway and Finland probably being either top three or all top five, with some Nordic country winning next year's Eurovision. We still have a few songs to come, yeah, to, you know, be presented for Eurovision 23, but it will be hard. It will be hard to beat this. It will be probably the first time in history of Eurovision that Sweden, Norway and Finland will compete for the top three and will probably make it all at least to top five. Wow, wow, wow. Now, these are my thoughts. What do you think of the song? Now, what do you prefer? Euphoria or Tutu? Do you think Loreen can repeat her success? Do you think she can win twice? That will be the first case. I believe Eurovision has been won twice by the same person. Will it be a letdown if she gets the second place? What do you guys think? Please write and let me know if you agree with my comments on the staging, on her vocals, on the comparison to Euphoria. Let me know. Thank you so much for watching. Stay with Blogovision. Give me a like, share if you've enjoyed my reaction. And if you didn't, well, make your own and I want to see it. Bye!